So the next one actually adalah the approximation from binomial to normal. Ada dua approximation, daripada binomial to normal and daripada Poisson kepada normal. So we need to memorize the condition when you need to approximate daripada binomial kepada normal. Sebelum ni ada approximation kan daripada daripada binomial kepada Poisson bila n ataupun sample size is large kan. Bila sample size is large, kita kena tengok pula dia punya nilai probability. Nilai probability close to zero or not. Okay, kalau close to zero, it very small. Nilai probability of P, nilai P, probability of success is very small. So, we can approximate kepada Poisson distribution. Ataupun, we can check using the formula of N multiplied by P. Okay. Alright. So, another one adalah approximation daripada binomial kepada normal. Okay, so dia punya conditionnya adalah the first one is when n is large. So, if the situation ataupun our case study is belong to the binomial distribution. Okay, first thing first, tengok dulu dia punya sample size is large or small. Kalau small, so tak ada masalah, kita proceed dengan binomial distribution. Nak cari nilai probability, nak cari mean, nak cari variance and MGF semua, boleh gunakan binomial distribution. Nak dapatkan nilai probability, dapatkan nilai mean, dapatkan nilai variance, boleh proceed dengan binomial formula ataupun binomial function PDF kan, distribution. Tapi kalau n is large, kita tengok balik. Kalau sample size is large, kita kena buat approximation sama ada kepada normal ataupun kepada Poisson. It depends pada P. Okay, it depends pada P ataupun probability of success. Okay, if probability is success ni ataupun nilai P is very small, okay, kita akan approximate kepada Poisson. But if P is not extremely close to 0 or 1. Okay, kalau not very close to 0 or 1, which is P is close to half, 0.5. So, kita akan approximate kepada normal distribution. Okay, N is large. N is more than 30. And P close to 0.5 ataupun 1 over tu. So kita kena approximate daripada binomial yang asal tadi adalah binomial. Okay, yang asal tadi binomial, contohnya let's say our variable is x here. So x first adalah binomial with parameter n and p. And then because of n is more than 30 and p is close to 0.5, ataupun kita boleh check lagi satu kan, gunakan np. If np is more than 5, so kita kena approximate kepada normal distribution. Normal distribution kena ada mean dan variance kan. Dia punya parameter untuk normal distribution adalah mean dan variance. Dia punya parameter. So now macam mana nak cari mean dan this mean and this variance kan? Sebab sekarang ni kita punya distribution tak approximate kepada normal, so nak cari nilai probability kena gunakan normal distribution. So in order to find the probability gunakan normal, kena ada parameter dia, kena ada value mu dan value sigma square. So how to do that? So how to find that? So mu nya tadi, bila dah buat approximation, mu nya akan jadi n multiply by p, variance nya adalah np 1 minus P ataupun NPQ. Dapatkan mana daripada N dan P ni? Daripada sini lah, daripada binomial distribution tadi kan. Kita ada value N dan value P. So, dapatkan value, dapatkan nilai mu dan sigma square first. Then, we can use the normal distribution to find the probability. Okay. So, untuk normal distribution, as before this, like I said before this, kita nak cari nilai probability when the variable is comes from the normal distribution, we need to use the normal table, standard normal table. So, kena buat transformation. Bila buat transformation, kena tukar daripada X tadi kepada Z. Okay, so kena buat transformation. We need to multiply the X with mean, which is sekarang ni, meannya adalah NP. And divide dengan standard deviation. So, now the standard deviation will be square root of NPQ. Q adalah 1 minus P. Okay. And then, another one adalah kena buat, bila buat approximation daripada binomial ke normal, kena buat continuity correction. Sama ada value X tadi kena minus dengan 0.5 ataupun plus dengan 0.5. Okay, kenapa kena buat continuity correction? Sebab binomial ke normal, binomial adalah discrete variable, normal adalah continuous. So, kita kena tukar dan nak approximate daripada binomial ke normal, daripada discrete kepada continuous, kena buat continuity correction. Before this, binomial kepada Poisson tak perlu buat a correction, sebab binomial dan Poisson, both of them adalah discrete, from the discrete random variables. Okay. So, bila dah approximate kepada normal, kena buat continuity correction. So, macam mana continuity correction ni? Maybe you still ingat lagi. Let's say, kita nak cari probability of X. Okay, more than value of K, kan? So, what to do is, first thing first, sebelum cari probability tu, kena buat continuity correction dulu. K tadi kena plus 0.5. If more than K, so we need to plus 0.5. If more than, kena plus. Kalau less than, it will be less than K minus 0.5. If X more than equal, it will be minus. If it is less than equal, it will be plus. Okay, terbalik eh. More than K, plus 0.5. More than equal K, minus 0.5. Less than K, minus 0.5. Less than or equal to K, plus 0.5. Kena plus 0.5. Alright. Okay, let's see the example here. 40% of UiTM students in the main campus were provided a hostel accommodation. If 100 students are selected at random, find the probability that more than 45 students are not provided hotel accommodation. Okay, so first thing first, dekat sini, kena tengok dulu. The situation here is comes from the binomial situation. Kan? Okay. Dekat sini, dia bagi you nilai P. Okay, first thing first, cuba determine dulu the variable. Variable adalah number of students. Number of students not provided hostel accommodation. Right? So, nilai P di sini adalah 0.5. Dan N adalah 100. Okay, so X adalah binomial with parameter N100 and P 0.5. Okay, so here, because of N is large, tengok terus bila binomial, kita kena tengok dia punya n. Large ke small? Kalau small, boleh proceed dengan binomial. Kalau large, kena approach limit sama ada kepada poison ataupun kepada normal. So, but so now, because of n is large, more than 30, but p is 0.4, which is apa ni, close to 0.5, ataupun another way, we can find that n multiply p, which is 100 multiply 0.5, kita akan dapat 40, right? Which is more than 5. So, because of that, kita approximate kepada normal. Kita approximate kepada normal. Dan jadi, normal with mean mu dan variance sigma square. So, how to find the mu? It will be NP dan NP. So, sebab because of that lah, kena cari nilai NP first. Okay, here NP, let's say kat sini is 40, so here N is 40 and NPQ is 24, yeah, so it will be 24. Okay, so soalannya nak cari the probability that more than 45 students not provided. More than 45 students not provided. So it is nak cari probability of x tadi lah. X more than 45. Okay, here. So because of more than, I think sebab kita buat approximation, so kena buat continuity correction. Because of that, kena k tadi kena plus dengan 45. 0.5. So, at first kat sini actually adalah ni dulu lah. Dan dia sama juga dengan probability of X more than 45 plus 0.5. And then because of kita nak gunakan standard normal table, sebab tu kita akan tukar kepada Z. Okay, bila tukar kepada Z, kena tolak dengan its mean dan divide dengan its standard deviation. Okay. So, 45 plus 0.5 minus 40 divided by square root of 24. And then, yang lain-lain, tengok macam biasa, macam sebelum ni. Okay, Z, last week, you akan dapat probability of Z more than 1.12. And then, boleh tengok table. 1.12, here. So, that's, here, 1.12. So, 0.1314. Okay. Right. So, first thing first. Bila the case study is comes from binomial distribution. So, kita tengok dia punya sample size sama ada large ataupun small. Okay. Bila large, kita test NP-nya. Kita tengok nilai probability of success sama ada it's very small ataupun it's close to 0.5. Let's see another one. A survey of college senior revealed that 70% disapprove of daily pot smoking. Case random samples of 1 to 0 seniors were selected in order to get more opinion regarding to this issue. What is the probability that less than 49 of the seniors approve the smoking pot daily? Okay. So, soalan, information given here adalah 70% of the senior disapprove. Tapi soalan, dia nak yang approve. So, from the start, kita cari terus distribution untuk approve. Tapi dia bagi information about this approve, then we can automatically know the distribution ataupun the percentage of approve about the smoking pot daily. Okay, 70% disapprove, so 30% approve lah, betul tak? Alright. So, let's see, kita buat 1. Y, dia variable adalah number of college senior approve. Info given disapprove, tapi saya determine the variable as approve. Sebab kita nak jawab soalan nanti, soalan untuk approve. Dia punya variable untuk approve. So, information is given about this approve, which is P0.7. But because of we determine the variable as senior approve, the smoking pot daily, so P adalah 0.3. Q will be 0.7 ataupun 1 minus P. And N is 1 to 0. So, because here N adalah large, and then P is close to 0.5. It is not very small. Okay, ataupun kita boleh check lagi satu. Boleh gunakan NP. 130 multiply 0.3. It is 39, which is more than 30, more than 5. And boleh check lagi satu untuk NQ juga. NP atau NQ, which is 130 multiply 0.7. Both of them, you can check both of them. 130 multiply 0.7, it is 91. Which is more than 5. Okay, both of these is more than 5. And P, N, and Q is more than 5. So, we can proceed with normal approximation. Kalau one of that sahaja yang fulfill the condition more than 5, so kita proceed dengan Poisson. And then, usually the P is very small. Okay, P is very small. Kita proceed dengan Poisson. Alright. So, kita approximate Y kepada normal, normal distribution with mean 39 and variance adalah, kita cari NPQ. Will be 2.73. Alright. So, soalannya dia nak cari probability of Y less than 49. So, first thing first, kena kena buat continuity correction first. 49 minus 0.5, but they're less than. And then because of we want to use the standard normal table, so we need to minus the value with its mean and the standard deviation. NPQ ni actually adalah 27, right? 27.3. So here is also it is 1.8. Okay. So, because of here, kita nak put the offset last time. Test the nilai yang positif, 1.8 here. So, kita nak value di sini. Okay. So, kita dalam table adalah value sebelah sini. So, it will be 1 minus put the offset more than positive value 1.8. So, it will be 1.82 is here. 1 minus 0.0344. It will be 0.9656. Okay. Alright, so that is for normal approximation to the binomial. So another one adalah normal approximation to the Poisson. Okay, untuk Poisson pula. Okay, so as you know, we use the we use the Poisson distribution for the situation of when we deal with the time and then the period of time. Kan? So kita gunakan Poisson. Okay. So tetapi bila parameter untuk Poisson adalah mu, which is the average ataupun mean. Tapi bila meannya, okay, if and only if mean is more than or equal to 20, kita tak boleh lagi gunakan Poisson distribution. Kita kena approximate kepada normal distribution. Okay, if and only if dia punya mean untuk Poisson distribution tadi, parameternya mu is more than or equal to 20. So, kita kena approximate kepada normal distribution. Okay, so normal distribution, parameternya adalah mean dan variance. Mean dan variance. So, how to find the mean and the variance for this distribution? So, kita ambil mean dan variance daripada Poisson distribution yang asal, which is mean dan variance untuk Poisson adalah mu. So, because of that, kat sini kita akan gunakan mean, mu and sigma square yang sama untuk mean. This is the parameter itself. Okay. Alright, so let's see the example here. Suppose the number of babies born during a day shift at the hospital followed a Poisson distribution, okay, with the mean of 6 hours. So, dia punya apa ni? Dia punya parameter. Okay, parameternya adalah mean kan, average, which is the 6 per hour. So, if we can determine the variable first, which is the number of babies born. A day. Suppose the number of babies born during a day shift. Okay, a mean of 6 per hour in an hour lah. So, X is the number of babies born per hour. Sebab dia bagi average tu untuk per hour. So, dia punya parameter mu ataupun lambda ni last 6 untuk per hour. Last 6. Okay. So, soalannya, what is the probability that during a particular 4-hour period, okay, 4-hour period, less than 20 babies were born. So, kita nak cari nilai probability ni. X less than 20. Tapi, untuk 4-hour period, okay, tadi X kita yang asalnya adalah number of babies born per hour, lambdanya adalah 6. So, Y pula adalah number of babies. Kita punya variable yang kita nak tahu adalah babies for babies born in 4 hour. So dia punya min ataupun lambdanya tak boleh lagi ke 6 lagi lah. Sebab 6 tu untuk per hour, so it will be 6 multiply 4, which is 24. So because of 24 is more than 20, so kita punya condition tadi, so because of that lah kita kena approximate kepada normal distribution. So y tadi kena approximate kepada normal with mean 24 dan variance 24. Okay. And then because of the approximation daripada Poisson kepada normal ni adalah Poisson discrete dan normal adalah continuous. So kena buat juga continuity correction. So because this is less than 20. So first kena buat dulu, kena tolak dulu dengan 0.5, barulah minus dengan its mean, divide dengan its standard deviation. Okay. So we'll do this one. Okay, z less than negative 0.92. Di sebelah negatif kat sini. Okay. Dia sama juga dengan yang sebelah positif. So it is equal dengan z more than positive 0.92. So boleh tengok table terus je. So that's it. Okay, let's see lah another questions. Recent primary pulse indicated on the average 3 motorcycle theft occur each minute. 3 motorcycle theft occur each minute in the urban area. What is the probability that there is at least 20 theft in 9 minutes? So, first thing first, determine our variable first. Kita terus kepada tengok apa yang variable yang kita nak cari kat sini lah. Nilai probability adalah theft untuk 9 minutes. So, the determine the variable y ni untuk 9 minutes lah. Okay, number of theft. Motorcycle theft in 9 minutes. So, dia punya average adalah average of motorcycle theft in 9 minutes lah. Tadi dia beritahu 3 ni untuk each minute. So, it will be 3 multiplied by 9, 27. Okay. So, nak cari probability of Y. At least. Paling sikit 20. So, more than or equal to 20 theft in 9 minutes. So, maksudnya kita kena, kita akan gunakan variable Y lah. Okay. So, more than or equal to. So, because of lambda is more than 20, kita approximate kepada normal. Will be normal with mean 27 and variance 27. Okay, bila buat approximation, kita kena buat continuity correction. Here will be minus 0.5. Okay, sebab more than equal. Kalau more than saja, plus. More than equal, minus. Tolak dengan 27, divide dengan square root of 27. So, it will be. So it will be more than negative 1.44. So negative value di sebelah sini, negative 1.44. So sini lah. Okay. So it will be sama juga dengan 1 minus probability of z less than negative 1.44. So negative 1.4 less than negative 1.44 sama juga dengan z more than positive 1.44. Right? So it will be 1 minus 1.44. 0.0749. Okay, so the final answer will be 0.9251. Right? So that's the way how to do the approximation between this.